Since 1982, Kilembe Mines has been in a limbo following its closure during political turmoil in Uganda, proceeded with some of the lowest copper prices on international market. 2 years since, the Chinese consortium led by Tibet Hima Industry Limited took over the management and operations of Kilembe. The condition of Kilembe is not the same, as most of the dilapidated infrastructure is being overhauled.
Installations. We are building and assembling tram cars for use underground, and the mill has already been dismantled, part of it. We have built new foundations for the new machines. We expect to have them by next month. So there is a lot of work being done. Underground, we have removed all the old equipment. We are replacing with the new equipment, trucks, transformers. We have already installed three compressor units underground. We have brought new drill machines. Next week we are beginning drilling for exploration and for small-scale mining. So there is a lot of work going on.
With a consortium of six Chinese companies with expertise in copper mining, iron, steel and smelter technologies, hydropower technical and development, and vast expertise in cable and transformer manufacturing, it is a matter of time for Kilembe Mines to rise to its former glory as demand for copper rises in tiger countries, driving the prices up. Kilembe Mines sits on 58 square kilometers of copper belt in Rwenzori Mountain, 7 kilometers north of Kasese town. Between 1956 and 1971, during Kilembe Mines operations, 16.2 million tons of copper graded at 1.98% and cobalt graded at 17% were mined, and approximately 270,000 tons of blister copper produced. During this period, mining centered mainly on the eastern part of the mines, leaving the southwestern deposits for the future, now estimated to be over 5 million tons commercially viable for 25 years. Till tomorrow afternoon, when we bring you another episode of Kilembe Mines in Explore Uganda, I'm Harris Thembo.